My name's Tyeisha Clark. I'm from Kaunyama. My people are the Kokoperen people and Yoruman. Kaunyama is a language name meaning the place of many waters. Everybody is a happy-go-lucky person. A new person come in town, everybody is so curious. They'd be like, who are you? What you doing here?
With more than 1,000 residents, Kaunyama is one of the larger towns on Queensland's Cape York Peninsula. And lately, the boisterous chorus of corellas has been competing with the sound of another bird, of the fixed-wing variety. Tyeisha is training to be the community's first pilot.
I love the thought of travelling, really. Travelling around, seeing places is beautiful.
To achieve her ambition, Tyeisha's had to attend a flight school on the New South Wales Tablelands. Locals are happy to celebrate the cold, but not this Queenslander.
My nose, I can't feel my nose really, and I think my nose hates this cold weather, but I cannot wait to get back up in the warm.
It's okay. Full.
Perfect.
Yep.
Oh. She's just really involved in what we're doing and, you know, is loving the training, so it makes her a good student.
It's a lot of work.
Oh, I'll put you
back into it. There!
There we go. Woo.
So how did she get here? It all started last year with a chance encounter with the owner of a flight school.
John walked in with this ukulele and then me and him had a conversation. He's teaching me to play the ukulele.
I'm here with Tyeisha. She's 20 here in Kaunyama, Mama. What did you just learn? What did we learn, Tyeisha?
I watch the dust.
But Tyeisha had other things on her mind.
And then I said, you know, I'm going to make you a rock star, Tyeisha. And she said, I don't want to be a rock star. I want to be a pilot.
After 6 months of study, she's well on her way.
I wouldn't think of myself becoming a pilot. It's amazing, the feeling up in the air. It's really amazing.
Tyeisha's elders and her family are her biggest motivation.
I feel very warm and fuzzy when they say they're proud of me, and I've always wanted to do something to give back to them.
For her to follow her dreams, I'm the proudest little sister.
The entire community is proud. Its children captivated.
Huge inspiration for the community, for little kids, and yeah, for Tyeisha herself as well.
Six a.m. and a chilly 4 degrees. Tyeisha's about to embark on a journey that was once a distant dream.
We're flying from Bathurst all the way to my home community in far north Queensland, Kaunyama.
I know that people are coming from far and wide to see us arrive.
The engine hours are 968.0 and the total hours is 969.7.
Okay, great, thanks.
I'm excited, I'm nervous, I'm cold from the weather, but I'm really excited for today.
The time has come for Kaunyama's daughter to return home. Departing Bathurst, Tyeisha's piloting her ultralight more than 2,300 kilometres, a journey that'll take 2 days.
It's very exciting to see the countryside and seeing beautiful places you've never seen before. For me, stepping on another man's land is it's very emotional. But doing this, it's very lovely, really. And seeing the outside world from the sky is amazing.
And as she nears home, excitement builds at Kaunyama Airport.
I'm coming back, flying back from a very long trip, and everybody's going to be seeing me flying, and my family's going to be there. It's going to be amazing.
She's flying the plane from Corumba to here, Kaunyama, and everyone's waiting for her, and I'm so excited right now.
To have a child from this community and a black woman to come in on a plane is just, for this little kid, the goal is a lot more attainable for the little black kid in the corner to be able to see a kid like them.
Tyeisha's father John is airside to record the textbook landing.
I'm proud because who would ever think that my own sister's gonna be famous? Like, it's unbelievable.
Everybody everywhere was a very long old trip coming.
Congratulations to you, my granddaughter.
My heart was pumping as fast. I was nervous. I was excited. Everything was just so emotional. I had to double take on how many people there were here.
Celebration's over. Tyeisha and her family head back to their favourite spot.
Let's do your hair.
John Clark reflects on the significance of his daughter's flight.
I'm very proud of where she achieved now. It's a good way of showing that our Indigenous kids, if they really put their minds to doing something, they can achieve it.
How are you?
Good.
We're going flying. Yeah, you excited?
Yes.
A kilometre down the road, the next generation of Barefoot Pilots are already dipping their toes into the cockpit.
This is my first time going on a small plane, and I'm really excited for it.
OK, there you go. Click it in. Good. Thumbs up. Very nice.
And if these kids ever follow in her flight path, Tyeisha's proud to have been a role model.
For them to see that they can become anything they want if they put their mind to it and stick to it.
Beautiful story. Great I love story, her as well. Huh? She had the aviators on as well, yeah. The real Top Gun moment there. And more than just breaking down barriers, she'll be keeping those communities connected because it's vast.
The significance of something like that in community, from community, being able to provide those links is huge. But I love that our team asked her what she wanted to do with this and what her ambitions were. And she said astronaut.
So there you go.
Damn. The sky genuinely is the limit. Yeah. Tyeisha is now helping launch the Barefoot Academy to help others in remote communities. So if you're a business and you'd like to help sponsor the initiative, as you can see, it's a pretty terrific one. Please head to our website.